Hi everyone, let's have a little bit of a closer look at how you can get the most out of your lunges. Now, those of you who've been training with us for quite a while at Switch will have noticed that the lunge exercise is something that we use throughout lots of our toning, sculpting and fat burning workouts. So I want to spend an extra few moments giving you a few little tips and pointers to make sure that every single rep that you make is the best it can be. So let's go into a lunge. So join me with this. The best way of learning is doing it yourself. So let's choose our right leg and let's step into that lunge at first. So we lunge ourselves forward and back. Now I want you to do this a few times just to feel how the mechanics of the movement are, how it feels through the ankle, how it feels through the knee, how you feel, how you're moving in the right or wrong ways, where you feel the stress onto the muscle tissue. And then what we're going to do is try and slow this right down and correct it. So let's lunge that right leg back in. Now what I'm going to do is take you into the wrong movement, something that we often make ourselves, and that's the easiest way to work back into the right movements. So let me take you a lunge. The first thing that most people do wrong is they don't step quite far enough. When the foot hits the ground, our body weight travels further forward, and can you see what's happened to my knee there? It's crossed way beyond the heel, even beyond the toe, and I can already start to feel a little bit of pressure on the kneecap and just below the kneecap and onto that patella and the patella tendon. Now first of all, it means that we're not performing the exercise right, so we're not going to get the most out of it. And also, we're going to put that extra pressure on the knee, which could lead to an injury somewhere down the line. So let's make that first correction. So let's make our stride nice and long, and then we'll go into our second point. So as we go into that lunge, second teaching point I want to focus on is that we make sure the heel's ground, so we make sure that it is placed onto the ground. Again, a common thing that most people do, they begin to roll over onto the toes and you can feel that heel lift. Now I want you to do that at home. Can you feel that extra bit of pressure onto your calf? Again, beginning to tighten the calf up, which is what we don't want. So press the heel down and we're gonna bend the knee. So we're gonna make sure that our body weight sits over the heel. Then we're gonna lift the spine nice and tall. We're not gonna gape all the way forward, rounding the spine, humping the back. So we go down onto the heel, spine sits nice and tall, and then pushing through the heel, we stride back. Now the most important thing about pushing through the heel is that it means that we activate more muscle tissue. It means that the back of our legs and our glutes, our bum muscle, they begin to contract harder, meaning that your exercise will be performed better, but also you get more out of every rep. So you're toned quicker, you burn more calories, and your body becomes more efficient at exercise. So let's have a go of those pointers. So let's stay with the right leg. Let's stride it in. Remember what we said first. Make sure that stride's nice and long. So don't let it become too short. We're not putting pressure on the knee then. And then when I push back, I fire through the heel and I drive myself back. Let's switch it. Let's see how your left leg does. So let's stride it in, kick through the heel and take us right back. Now there's one more thing that I want to bring into play with a lunge. And it's something that makes lunge a really great exercise for us. It's how we activate our core during a lunge. Now again, those of you who trained with us over the last few weeks will have noticed that we constantly talk about pulling the tummy in, drawing the belly button into the spine, activating your core. Now with a lunge, we can work our core more than most exercises. Because we're unbalanced, the body has to tense up its core to stop us falling over. So let's enhance that. Let's make your lunges an abdominal exercise. So let's go back to this right leg. As we stride into the right leg and the foot hits the ground, draw the belly button in. Tighten the tummy up, drive through the heel, step it back. Let's do the same on the left leg. Stride it down, draw the belly button in, feel that difference, that little bit of a split second maneuver, and kick it back. Right, let's make you more dynamic to finish the session. Let's go alternate legs. Focusing on all those teaching points, drawing the abdominal area in. Ready? Come and join me. So we lunge, abs, yeah. So that's how we go. So we lunge and abs come in. So constantly we're getting that contraction through the tummy. We're making sure the heel doesn't cross beyond the knee so the glutes are still tensing up also. And finally, my spine sat nice and tall. Let's go for one more rep each side at home. Stride in for me, root it down, and there we go. Practice that a few times. Don't be afraid of stopping exercise for a few moments, hitting pause on the workout and making sure you're getting that technique absolutely perfect. We don't want you injured, and we want every single second that you join us here at Switch to be the most effective and benefit for your body. Thank you for joining with me. I'll see you next time in workout. Take care.